Uncle Boonmi, who can recall his past lives. An indie film from Thailand made in 2010, but looking much older than that, not the least thanks to the 16mm film stock used. It is perhaps the weirdest movie I have ever seen, certainly near the top of that list. It's very slow, very indirect, difficult to digest and even to understand. I think it's best described as a mood piece, where it doesn't necessarily tell you a straightforward, specific, linear story, instead trying to create a specific atmosphere in each of its sections. The main theme of the film is dying, the final gathering of thoughts and reassessing your life before doing so, before death. The main character, Uncle Boonmi, is this older man with some kidney problems who suspects he's going to pass soon. And in his final days, he spends time working on this rural farm. He enjoys food and talking to his family members, including the ghost of his deceased cousin and her son, who is living in the woods as a sort of monkey, human, monster, woodland spirit kind of hybrid with red glowing eyes. And I'm not joking, by the way. He also slips in and out of some fantasy worlds or dreamlike states and eventually goes on a trek to the cave that he was born in. All these sections of the film are slightly different from the others, and each of them is quite slow and uneventful. They have this vibe of kind of like a warm afternoon or an evening where you just sit with your thoughts and perhaps with other people without anything specific to do. It's quasi-philosophical with its themes and also properly weird, especially that section with the ghost and the monkey monster. Apparently, the whole thing was meant by the director to be not just about human death, but also in a wider sense about the dying of cinema as an art form, and more specifically as a format, a film as a format. He said that celluloid film is dying away and everybody today shoots digital, which I don't think I necessarily agree with as a concept. I mean, 10 years on, we still have a lot of indie directors deciding to shoot on film. Some major players going on as well, like Quentin Tarantino or Christopher Nolan. So I'm just not 100% convinced by the movie's thesis. And even more importantly, I wouldn't have guessed what exactly it was if the director didn't tell me. There is certainly a feeling of passing, of change, death, moving into the inevitable past, but I don't think the cinema connection is that clear. So overall, for some people, you know, the nature of the film will be something to appreciate, surely. I mean, the movie won Cannes, and it was praised by many critics, and I like to think that my taste is somewhat refined by this point. I can certainly appreciate slower, more introspective piece, but this one goes too far in that direction, even for me. I found myself kind of nodding off, wondering when it's going to end or where it's actually going, if anywhere. There were moments where I bought into his atmosphere, but also moments which felt a bit too much for me, too artsy, too abstract. It kind of felt, at times it felt like Stalker by Andrei Tarkovsky, but even more unusual and odd. So it's certainly not for everyone. I think casual viewers especially will just turn it off after 10 minutes, and that's fine. I mean, some other people will probably enjoy it more for what it is, and that's also fine. I find myself somewhere in the middle, where I think I kind of understand what the intent was, and some of the parts worked for me, but not completely. And I'm just not entirely sold on the film being a masterpiece that some critics painted it to be.